In my previous video, I tried to repair this TWS and you saw that my mission was failed because there is three battery in this total setup, two earpiece and one main unit. And one of these earbud is completely dead, battery is completely dead, but it has little bit capacity on it, but it is not enough for use as a headphone. So I think I will reuse it. I will use this case for my NodeMCU. A few days ago, I make this one. This one has only one module, but sometimes we need two modules at a time. And this case has not enough space for two modules at a time. So I will use this case. This case is bigger than this one, and it has more space than this one. So I will use it instead of it. Let's see what can we do. We don't need this thing at all. Then we have to replace its battery because it is not good. Let's open this case. Okay, it is open. It is the empty shell. They use a small battery instead of 18650. I will use a 18650 battery, so I need some more space. I don't need this thick foam. Let's clean it. Foam residue, clean it. I have to use this part, and my plan is to remove this battery and this display too, because I don't need the display. Open this ribbon cable, remove everything. Okay, I have to check one thing, that without the display is working or not. Okay. This is the charging cable. I insert. What's the problem? The port is, there is some problem in this port. I think some soldering issue. I have to solder it before try to use, or it will break. I have to open the board. Now I will try it. Soldering done, and now cleaning. I think now it is okay. And now I will check the output voltage. Is it okay or not? Yes, 4.26. I think it's okay. 4.26 and 1.11. Why it is jumping like that? It is jumping like a monkey. Now say, is it stable with display? It gives stable voltage 4.2928 with display connected. But if I disconnect the display, then it acts weird. It's jumping. It's jumping. But what can I do? My space is so small, so I cannot fit too much thing in this little compartment. What can I do? Let's see. Okay, then I'll try to keep it. If I can't, if we cannot fit this with our new battery, then I have to do one thing. I have to use another charging module. This battery is a small size and it will help us for fit everything inside this box. This one is better. I don't have to see this display, but I only have to keep it in this box, because without this our battery will not charge. So what I will do, I will put this display board somewhere in here, and this plastic makes some space. We need more space. Finally, we can manage some space for our display in here. It will connect like this and stay like this. Now it's time to connect our new battery, 18650. Start with positive, connected, then negative, connected. Nice. Okay, now we have to make some space in here so we can keep our two NodeMCU. Remove this one from previous box. I will use some insulator between two modules, but it will actually stay like this. Okay, in here. So we have to cut some space from here. Let's move and see what can I do. For safety purpose, I will dismantle this board and battery from this body. After cutting and finishing, then we will put it back again. You see, this plastic is transparent, and I will try to remove this. Okay, try to use some thinner. If they glue it, then maybe thinner will close the joint, or we have to cut down. Now this is so hard, so we'll go hard line too. this part is not important for us, so we can just cut. After all cutting and trimming, it looks like this. So now reinstall the board. It has two screws, screw them all. Battery is here. Our display is ready to connect. Let's connect it. So now I will see, is there enough space for our NodeMCU? I think this space is enough. Battery connected, display in its position and connected with board. I think now I can assemble the back part. But the thing is, how can I power them? I have to connect them directly from the battery. Of course, I will install two separate switch for each of them. How? Here is my NodeMCU one. Here is my second NodeMCU. Here is some empty space. Here is two. Then if I keep it like this, one is here and another in here. Now our voltage input. This is our voltage input, and this is this one I will connect from here. One switch will be here and another be here. And now I will see which switch I can use in this project. Okay, I will install the two switches. One is here and another is here. Then there will be my board. I installed these two switches in here. Of course, it doesn't look so good, but I don't care. There will be a cover here, something like this, so nobody will know what's inside. This is our final thing. I take negative connections from board, this one for one module, here from another module, and positive side we solder directly from the battery here to one switch, and then here to here another switch. After switching, it is our positive line. Now we will see our voltage. Okay, here voltage. Okay, now we have to put this main shell inside the shell. Here is our front cover. Oh, don't do this to me. This is the cover, this is everything else. After installing everything, it looks like this. Nobody will understand what the heck inside this box. One, two. Yes, no problem at all. Now our job is to connect our module ground to ground, voltage in to positive. Now this one, same, ground to ground, positive to voltage in. What's now? This is the problem. I cannot put it just like this without any protection, one after one. Okay, I will use this two feet shrink tube for protection. I will not shrink it, I just put it like this, just like this, without shrinking. Oops, what's the problem? Oh no, it's not fit in here with this shrink tube. No, it's a big challenge. Oh, I can't put two of them with shrink tube. If only lower one is protected and upper one is not protected, I think it will be okay. What? Oh, what is this? It shrink tube, just push it to the outside. Without it shrink tube, it is fit nicely. But I have to do something. No. Yes. Now it is okay. I just put one module, then a slice of fit shrink tube, then another board. Now it is working fine. I don't need to open this cover too much, only for switch on and switch off. Nice. Okay, this is our final product. Now it is charging. From this angle we can see something is happening inside the box. Our display is lighting. Then open the cover and you will see two NodeMCU modules lying here, and there is two switch for power them up. This one powered, second one power on two. Okay, now we will see if it is working or not. Here we see the two SSID of this two module. You just can Google this name and you will understand what is happening here. Thank you for your time.